Let's first look at the on-chain code, the actual Plutus code. And it's very similar to the NFT example that I presented in the previous lecture. So if you recall the trick to mint a true NFT, a native token of which there can only ever be one coin, is to insist on a specific UTXO being spent by the minting transaction. And because, as I explained last time, UTXOs are unique and can only ever exist once. Once they have been spent, there can never be the same UTXO again. So there can only be a single minting transaction. And then in the case of NFTs, if you insist on the amount being minted to equal one, then you are guaranteed to have an NFT. There can only be a single minting transaction. And in that transaction, only one coin is minted. So only one coin in total can ever exist. So that's how you can do NFTs in Plutus. So I basically just copied this example from the last lecture, but I made it a little bit more general so that you can't only do NFTs. You can, in this one minting transaction, mint an arbitrary amount. So I now take three parameters for this policy, this minting policy. The TX outref, the reference to the UTXO, that is to be consumed, spent by the minting transaction. Then the token name, and this integer is the amount, how many coins you want to mint. So we don't need a redeemer, so that's just unit, and then as usual the script context, and the result is bool. So it's very similar, as I said, to last time. We must check two conditions, namely that the specified UTXO has indeed been spent and that the right amount has been minted. And this is as before. So this has UTXO is the same as in the last lecture, but the check minted amount is now slightly different, because in the last lecture I checked that this minted amount is 1, and now I check that it equals the second parameter to the contract. Then we have the usual boilerplate to turn this Haskell code into an actual Plutus minting policy. So we do the usual template Haskell thing, and we have to lift the three parameters into Plutus and apply them to this compiled Plutus code to get our minting policy. And once we have that, we can also compute the corresponding currency symbol. So that's all. That's our on-chain code.